Have you ever experienced a beautiful mountain snowfall? Snow is arguably one of the most celebrated naturally occurring substances in the world. If anyone utters the word snow, the first image in your mind may be snow-capped mountains or a whitewashed sky of flurries. But have you ever wondered why this natural phenomenon occurs? Technically speaking, falling snow is just tiny crystals of frozen water that look a bit like small pieces of cotton. A snowflake is an ice crystal, or an amalgamation of ice crystals, that falls to the Earth from the atmosphere. Due to solar heating, there is continuous evaporation of water from rivers, lakes, and ponds around the globe. Now, it is important to note that water vapor is lighter than atmospheric air. Due to its low weight, water vapor rises higher in the atmosphere and transforms into clouds. As we go higher in the atmosphere, the temperature decreases. Simultaneously, the capacity of air to hold water vapor decreases as temperature decreases. At a certain height, the air becomes overloaded with water vapor and is said to be in a supersaturated state. At this point, the water vapor condenses on the smoke and dust particles mixed in the air. Upon further cooling, it turns into snow. These particles combine with each other to form snow crystals. When the air cannot bear the weight of these particles, they fall to Earth as snowflakes and blanket those regions at high enough altitudes. If you are trying to predict the likelihood of snow in your backyard, the possibility of snowfall in a given region depends on two key factors: the altitude of the region from sea level and the distance of the region from the equator. The higher the altitude of the region, the greater the possibility of it getting regular snowfall. Similarly, the greater distance from the equator, the greater chances of snowfall. Despite the fact that the amount of snow formed in the atmosphere is quite large, only a small fraction of it falls as snow. The remainder drizzles down as rain, because as the cloud of water vapor passes down the slope of a mountain, the temperature starts to rise, causing it to melt and turn into water. That's why it's somewhat rare to see snowfall in the plains, due to the role that temperature plays in the occurrence of snowfall. Although snowfall often takes place in hilly and mountainous regions, some geographical variations can lead to snow, even in low-altitude regions. For example, cold regions close to large lakes can witness snowfall, often called lake-effect snow. As cold, dry air flows across the lake, it gathers moisture and heat from the relatively warm water. This heated air rises, but gradually cools off, and the moisture it picked up from the lake condenses into clouds. If these clouds contain enough moisture or get supersaturated, they will produce snow as they run into land. Lake-effect snow can be seen near the Great Salt Lake in Utah, the Great Lakes of the Midwest, and large lakes throughout Canada and Europe.